Welcome to One Journey. Let's make it count. We're going to focus on life because together we thrive. Now, life has consequences. Your choices, your actions have consequences. So we can make better choices. We're going to talk about true crime. Now, we're going to link crime to the Bible. What is that sin? Then we're going to link it to the mental health community, where the psychiatrist, the psychologist, and the mental health professional put things together so we can understand what went wrong. And they also sometimes bring resolution. Now, we're also going to talk about the law of the land. So we're linking crime with the Bible, with the mental health community, and with the law of the land, so we can make better choices. Now, we only have one journey, so let's make it count. Welcome to One Journey. I'm your host, One Journey. Now, today we're going to talk about Janett Christman. Now, I would like you to remember to help support the channel by thumbs up, subscribe, post a comment, and share on social media or with your family and friends. And we'll always have the sources in the description box. Now, I wanted to tell you a little bit about why we're doing this story today. It was recommended by one of our viewers. Her name is Sheena. And she told us that this is one of her favorite stories and she really likes crime stories. So this is just for you, Sheena. And for all the other people that like the Janett Christman story. Now, Janett Christman, this is going to be her timeline. Born 4/21/1936, and then she died 4/18/1950. Yes, we're going back to the 50s. So let's get ready to go back to the 50s and look at what happened. Now, we want to express our deep regret for all the devastating loss that every family that experiences some sort of devastating loss, whether it's adultery, fornication, lasciviousness, witchcraft, oh, so many. And we're going to get to all of them. Stealing, you know, those things that God says, try to avoid some of those behaviors. Okay, so now we are going to go to Janett Christman's family's store. They had a store on the lower level, and on the upper level, that's where their home was. So they were always interacting with the community. And of course, because her dad was such a fabulous businessman and loved selling different things in his store, yep, she was dreaming about her store too. I am sure of it. Now, Janett had to put something together. Her birthday was coming. The 21st is going to be her birthday, and she has to be ready. Now, if anyone has ever put together an event, you know there is lots of notes to take, lots of things to check off. She knew she had to make money so she can babysit, get her dressed, and get her shoes. Let's walk through the journey with her. So here she is, and she's getting her shoes together, her clothes together, and it's 1950. First thing she had to do is get the music together because the music keeps us flowing. So she decided to pick out some of the Billboard hits. So in January, there was a hit. Guess what was still popping in January? Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Okay? Then the Andrews Sisters were popping off with I Can Dream. She's getting her music together. Then in February, it's almost March. Then in February, March. Oh my goodness, it's almost time for her birthday. This is March 21st is coming quick. And the music, and she's still, it's March now. The Cry of the Wild Goose, that's the hit thing. So she picked out her music. She knew what dress, she was gonna still looking for her dress. She's looking in the papers, guess where she was looking? Sears, the catalog, had everything, all the updated styles. And of course, she wanted to be stylish. She went through those catalogs, even if she had curls in her hair. She was going to figure it out. What I'm going to wear, what I'm going to show up in, call my uncle, looking good. I'm going to look great. She's got her plan. How she's going to make her money and what's going to what she's going to wear. Now she had to figure out the hairstyles. Oh my goodness, the 1950 hairstyles were creative. They weren't just wearing their hair hanging and flowing like that stupid Revlon commercial. They were doing fantastic things with their hair. Their hair was done. It wasn't just hanging like a horse's hair doing nothing, just hanging. No. It had style. It had pizzazz. And she was gonna make sure that her party was full of pizzazz. But guess what else? She needed to also plan the food. An American thing. Remember, she's already gone through the Sears catalog, and guess who she's gonna have? Sears started when? In 1892. That's when Sears started pushing out their catalogs through the mail. And of course, guess who was around? Coca-Cola. 1886. So in 1892, we had Sears, Roebuck's, sending all their catalogs out so you can make your choice of what you wanted. Also, she was gonna have Coca-Cola. Why? It's the real thing. Delicious. So she knew it's an American party, so we're gonna have hamburger, for sure. We're gonna cook out in the backyard, for sure. The guests can bring things too, why not? And she was gonna have hamburger, hot dogs, all the good stuff, including baked beans, honey, and corn on the cob, because it's her birthday. And she's getting ready to celebrate her 14th birthday. Man, on the 21st of March, it's gonna be her day, 1950. She's got the cake, she's got the chips, she's got everything ready. Why? She and her girls been planning, looking through the catalog, looking at all the windows, what's going on in the stores, looking at the catalog, and she's like, I'm gonna have my own store one day. It's gonna be the Janett Christman department store, and I'm gonna have the most beautiful things for all the female, every ages. Flat shoes, spike shoes, tall shoes, dresses for the evening as well as for the dance. She had it all planned, and her girlfriends, they went shopping like girls do, and they came back with stuff. They had food, they had clothes, they were ready, okay? Ready for this big event. Her birthday, happy birthday. And that's all she can think about. Happy birthday to me. In her 13-year-old mind, I'm gonna be 14, and mommy's gonna let me look good, and we're gonna have a good time in the backyard. It's my birthday. I've got my dress, I've got my shoes, and I'm looking good, and I got the money that I made. I'm making money. I gotta go to work tonight, make some more money. She's thinking. But guess what came? Something dark was moving around her. Cloaked. Couldn't see it. The Bible says they crept in unaware, and they were destructive. So sometimes evil creeps in, and you're unaware that a pedophile might be seeking you. Now, pedophiles, mental health community, they say, is a sexual perversion in which, I'm gonna read this now, a sexual perversion in which an adult or an adolescent experience a primary sexual attraction to prepubescent children. Now, in the United States, yearly 200,000 cases of pedophiles running around the country doing their thing. And you can check them by state. In 1950, they didn't have such restrictive laws like we have now. You need to sign in. We need to know where you live. No, you can't live near a school. Okay? But guess what? The pedophile, we're gonna call the pedophile the predator, was seeking. Ooh-wee. Can you imagine? So, the pedophile was stalking her. We're gonna use this ugly little crustacean roachy thing to be the predator. She just wanted to babysit. She just wanted to make some money. But the predator had plans for her. Everyone knew she was gonna have a birthday party. We share things. Everyone knew where it was gonna be. Everyone knows she's making that money to make it happen. 3 days away to the party. An event planner is already ready. Okay? They've got the people at the door that's gonna welcome everyone in. They've got their cards to sign with who's collecting the money. They're ready. She's ready. But a rapist interrupted, raped her, beat her, and killed her. She's 13. When you're 13, you're prepubescent. Your breast is up high. Your face is flawless. Well, sometimes you have some zits. But you're gorgeous. Why? Because you're moving into that age that you can have children. The boys got beards on their face, hairs on their arms. Woo! Looking good. And some people like stealing them and raping them. The predator was watching her. The dream killer was coming to destroy all her dreams, destroy her Janett Chapman store that she would have. And the predator came and killed her. What was really sad, 3 days away from her birthday, all that planning dismissed. She was born March 21st. Wow. And now it's 1950. Everything was moving. Pretty colored cars, everything. April, my apologies. April 21st, 1935. In April 18th, 1950, she dies. 13-year-old, shy of her 13th birthday. This is what the Bible says about that kind of sin. It says, whosoever ensnares, traps, catches, hunts, goes after. Children, my little ones, you know, we love babies over here. We love grandkids over here. We love children over here. He says, this is Matthew 18, 6 and 7. He says, whosoever ensnares one of these little ones, okay, who trusts me, it would be better for him to have a millstone hung around his neck and just jump in the sea and drown, because I'm coming for you. Oh, I repented. I'm coming for you. He's already told you, I'm coming for you. I'm glad you repented. I'm glad you did your time. He's still coming for you because you set a trap for someone innocent and young. That's not okay. Then the seventh verse says in that Matthew 18, it says, woe to the world because of snares. He says the whole world has snares, and woe means get your act together. Stop it. Whoa. I'm warning you. This is what Matthew 18 and 7 says. Woe to the world for snares, for there must be snares. Okay? Everything ain't gonna be rosy. Shh, didn't promise you a rose garden. Pay attention, parents. Snares and traps are out there for your children. It's in the music. It's in the community. It's in the school. Come on. It's in the church. Big time. Snares for your children. Everybody that grins and smiles at you, they may be lying. In the community. Anyway, it says, woe to the world because of snares. It says, woe to these because snares are very bad traps. But the person who sets the snares, he's going to set one for you. You trap someone, he's going to trap you. Woe to snares. November 11th, 1950, in Missouri, where she lived, they started really looking at pedophiles and saying, we gotta do better. We gotta protect our kids. So some punishment went up to 2 years for raping or hurting a child. 2 years. No, that person, they need life because or death, because that person is just going to come out and do it again because that's their sexual orientation. They have determined that's their sexual choice. Choice. We choose it. We're not born with it. We're all born in sin, yes, but you choose your choices. Remember, your actions, your choices, your actions have consequences. So in Missouri, the same year, in November, another one wasn't going to get away with it. And they said 2 year punishment for you in the state penitentiary. But now in 2021, they have something that's called the Equity Act. It's a new law that's going to change things. And it protects pedophiles. Well, you have to realize we've come a long way, baby. from being disgraced if you're shacking. Nobody cares anymore. Shack if you want to, blah, blah, blah. We don't care what God says. But the Lord says to marry. If you're burning, marry. You know, do the right thing. Put the ring on it, right? Marry. So nobody cares about that anymore. They're all shacking. Okay? Ignoring God. Okay? We're all ignoring what God says not to do. Well, now we're going a little deeper. Because the Equity Act says there is no question that the Equity Act would make pedophilia a special protected class of our environment. In daycares, school, sports, after school programs, and even your home worship. Come one, come all. You've got to figure out what snares are set up for you. Her father had a business. Her dream went cold. And now her parents have to bury her. She's gone. Birthday party not happening. All that preparation, cold. The predator came. And her life is over. And the community came to mourn the loss as well. Once again, the story was for Sheena, our viewer, that requested this. I want to thank you for your support and sharing your journey with One Journey. Please give us a thumbs up, subscribe, leave a comment, and tell me, how do you protect your children from predators? Do you know how to recognize the traps, the snares? Oh, I'm putting together a basketball team. Oh, I'm putting together a baseball team. Do you know how to recognize maybe your child been raped?